today. At my 50th birthday party, if my man DJ Pete throw on that WAP shit, I'm just going to start WAPing. Mm-hmm. Weibo. I just do the Weibo, the WAP, all that shit.
So this is something we... You wanted to talk about like immediately last week. We didn't. I don't think we got to it.
No.
It
I think happen. It broke.
Yeah, it broke right after.
Right after, like Friday. This yeah. kind of broke.
San Francisco. This guy named Dwayne Johnson was awarded $289 million.
$289 million stacks.
Because the weed killer Roundup was found to cause him terminal cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. you know what's crazy? Doctors said he wouldn't even live to see that trial.
Wow.
Yeah. That's
wow.
What, yeah.
Wow. And that same shit is in cereals.
Yes.
So I want to be clear with that. So this Monsanto, okay, we already know this is the artificial seed company, right? They're trying to create apples, oranges, and grapes with no goddamn seeds. So after you eat them, you can't even take the seeds from the shit you ate, plant them in your backyard, and make more apples. All right, the seeds is the information.
But is this like the water, the seedless watermelon stuff?
All of that. All of that. Monsanto is trying to get ahead of all of that and put a patent on the seeds. How are you going to put a patent on nature?
Mm.
Once we start allowing that to happen, things are starting to get very,
you
very...
You can't even collect rainwater.
Crazy. You can't even collect rainwater.
Yeah, so that should tell you something right there.
Okay, that should tell you you think you're free in this country, right? Yeah. Your ass can't even collect rainwater. All right? So these Monsanto projects, these artificial fruits and vegetables, which don't give you information anymore. You eat an apple in normal times... You know, when we were in tune with nature, the apple would give us information based on its origins, our surroundings, and so forth and so on. Now you just eating emptiness. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So this emptiness that we're doing and eating, Monsanto is branching on into a whole bunch of stuff and now has killed, he's not transcended yet. He hasn't made the transition. But goddamn, did you see him?
Yeah.
You know, he don't look too good, man, because he's been using that product. He's a gardener or
something. He's a school groundskeeper.
He's a school groundskeeper, and now he's out. So, but this will open up the gateway for a lot more people because I've been using Roundup, you know, on the terrace. I got a piece of potty grass, you know, where my dog makes his business.
I hear he's lying.
And I could be in line for some shit. I'm just saying. When people start lining up, I'm just putting it in the record now. I've been using Roundup, and I'm not feeling well. I don't give a fuck what y'all say about my kidneys. Nope. Roundup. So when they start cutting those checks, but hopefully this will get them to pay attention to how important this is.
Yo, it's just crazy how, like, soulless some people are. Like, you're trying to put a patent on seeds so people can't grow food, so only you could grow food?
Yeah. And they were selling fake seeds. I don't know if it was Monsanto. In Africa, South Africa, where the farmers are trying to take back their land, somebody was selling these motherfuckers fake seeds. And they shit wasn't growing. They're going, wait a minute. Shit should be growing by now. Fake seeds. I'm not putting that on Monsanto. I'm just simply saying I wouldn't be surprised. Because remember, we're moving more towards an artificial environment. I just ate a goddamn Impossible Burger.
From White Castle. Amazing.
From White Castle.
Amazing.
Right? Now, if you've never had one of these Impossible Burgers.
Incredible.
This is a plant-based burger. Right? This shit will make you smack your mama, right? I'ma be honest with you. Wifey drove by and she said, bro, they got these Impossible Burgers.
Yo.
I said, well, bring a couple of them shits on in. And from White Castle, so aesthetically, I grew up on White Castle. You know, so I'm saying, and now that I don't eat meat, you can't eat there. So now, you know, they got the onions on this shit. And wifey brought a few of these home. Nick, it's a wrap, right? And I told Malcolm, and Malcolm is very finicky. He's like, I was like, yo, bro.
First of all, when I think of White Castle, I just think of crackheads in front of White Castle.
Yeah.
That's what I think of.
Yeah.
Especially on 2/5.
Facts.
But just crackheads.
But when I grew up,
okay,
you know, late night, it was the only thing open at 2-3 in the morning.
Okay.
That after we came from the club, we can go to White Castle. Yeah. And the burgers was cheap. It was like 69 cent. So you can get 2-3 of those and, you know, some fries and you was good. Right? And I ingested this, but What I'm trying to say is,
it was incredible.
It was an incredible burger, but it wasn't real, right? So what's happening to our digestive system with now they are mimicking what food looks like
and tastes like.
And tastes like, yeah. Right? This is the scary shit. The Matrix has figured some shit out to say, okay, now we're going to give you some shit that look just like meat. When you bite into this Impossible Burger, you're going to swear this shit is meat.
I'm still not convinced, like
this shit. And this shit is plant-based because they're moving us into the next paradigm. It's a little thick, a little salty. You know, a little salty.
It was great.
And it's thicker than the traditional White Castle burgers. But me, you know, my mind gets, you know, running. I'm like, wait a minute. They're preparing us for this automated world. Where, like in the Matrix, when he was eating that slop and shit.
Yeah.
He was like, what the fuck? He said, yo, this is all the protein shit your body needs. And then he, he said, what does the Matrix know what chicken tastes like?
Mouse.
Yeah. Mouse, you know what I mean?
In the Matrix.
So now this, how the fuck do they make some shit that look and taste like beef like that? Right?
Yeah.
Pay attention. So while it was good, I'm not going to lie, shit was delicious. It's putting us on the line. So what do we have in the chat room? What are they saying? Get that money, Black Dot. I don't know. Get that money. Yeah, I'm going to get that money for that Roundup shit. Yeah, I'm going to get that. I cooked one of them Impossible Burgers when I was a vegan. I cooked it in my house, and the shit smelled gross. Okay, I mean, I don't know what you seasoned it with. I'm just telling you, TGIF got that Beyond Meat. Right. The Beyond Meat.
That's real plant-based.
That's real plant-based.
You can smell a plant.
Yeah, you damn near can smell a plant-based in that. But this one that they're making, this shit bleeds like a burger. So that's also telling me that it's something that they're, you know, trying out on us. Along with the auto-tune music, the, you know, Wi-Fi, the 5G that they're coming with. They're moving us to a point where they might not have to kill animals no more, which is great. You know what I mean? But we will be eating some artificial shit. Throw Monsanto's in there giving you apples and oranges that are artificial.
Yeah.
Laced with animal DNA so that it grows different. All of this shit is getting weird. Thought your storytelling is crazy, my guy. White Castle, that nasty shit. Yeah, facts. Facts. That's some nasty shit. But I'm going to tell you, that Impossible Burger is good, right? And I only say that because everything we do here is transparent. It, you know, if I trip and fall and eat a cheeseburger, I'll be the first one to say, bruh, I ate a cheeseburger. And I only say that because a lot of people are transitioning off of meat.
Yeah.
But they need the aesthetics. So that's where the whole faking bacon and all of that shit got a birth. You know what I'm saying? All of that shit ain't good for you. That tofu shit and soy shit. None of that shit is really good. You really got to go 100% plant-based. But who the fuck's going to do that, right? Except a few choice people and shit, right? So the aesthetics of knowing you used to go into White Castles, but now you can go in there and get something that's plant-based, even if it's transitional. See, I'm always looking at it from the perspective of transitioning, you know, and I promote the fake and bacon for those who are making a transition. I promote the conscious community for those who are coming out of church and who have been structured and need to loosen up. But the conscious community is not a final destination. It is a point for you to be deprogrammed, so to speak, and then move on your own personal journey of your knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. So all of these things have a role and a place. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like if you was on fucking heroin, they put your ass on methadone.
Which is the same thing.
Which is the same shit. But it was a liquid form of the shit.
Yeah.
To kind of transition you, and some people transitioned, and some people don't, and you know what I mean? So just keep that in mind when we're explaining this.
Yeah.
Ultimately, you want to just be a breatharian. I don't give a fuck. Just come out and breathe air, right? But until you do, right?
Yeah.
You have to make steps. People who smoke cigarettes, they go to the nicotine patch. Oh, that's just as crazy. It is, but it's the process in which some people are used to break themselves off of certain things. So, you know, keep that in mind as we talk about transitioning in anything. Mm-hmm. Transitioning is not easy. So for those who are on the fence and you want to see what a vegan burger tastes like, get that motherfucking Impossible Burger. Yeah. All right? You are tuned into the sounds of Urban X. Peace. This is the Black Dot, author of the underground classic Hip Hop Decoded and Urban Culture Decoded. For 15 years, I've been decoding hip hop, breaking it down, giving you it piece by piece, the DNA of hip hop, all of its multifaceted components. For the next 15 years, I want you to join me as I give you hip hop recoded and we put it back together, giving you its RNA so that we don't leave the next generation lost. But I have to give you a disclaimer. I am not a hip hop guru. This is not hip hop law. This is for pure entertainment purposes only. I am not a doctor. So before you take the red pill and go with us into the matrix of hip hop, consult your doctor to see if Hip Hop Recoded is for you. With that being said, we thank you for your patronage and we see you on the other side. Peace.